Okay, today's class, let us see, I'll be talking about projection of solids, isometric projection of solids. So let me take one problem and solve it. What's the problem? Draw isometric projection of a square prism of base 30 mm and axis length 60 mm. Okay, I'm drawing isometric projection of a square prism of base 30 mm and axis length 60 mm. So whenever we are drawing any solid part, it is must that we need to draw orthographic view here, and we start with the isometric projections later. So how do you start with the orthographic view? We have to start with the top of view and then the front view. So first, in the orthographic projections, we draw XY line. We represent VPHP as first quadrant, and then we draw a square of 30 mm. We draw a square of 30 mm or 40 mm. Okay. Is there a difference between this topic? So make it 40 mm. So draw a square of 40 mm. You have to draw a square, right? So 40 mm, 0 angle, 40 mm, 90 angle, 40 mm, 180 angle, then joining the corner. That is how we draw it. And then we name the locations of the corners. A1, BB1, CC1, DD1. Because it is a prism. A, B, C, D is the top face of the prism. A1, B1, C1, D1 is the bottom face of the prism. Joining the diagonals, we get the center of the prism. Then we project the lines so that we draw the front view. How to draw the front view? I have told 60 mm length, axis length. So you can take axis length here or this side. Both are parallel to each other. So we can draw the prism in the front view. Height are same for all the three lines. This line, the axis line, and the other line. All the three lines are equal to 60 mm, and then give the annotations. You should draw the annotations. That is very important for the orthographic view. Important for the orthographic view. Whereas for the isometric view, it is not required. Okay, this is how we draw the orthographic position of the prism in its front first position. That is what is required. Only the front position is required. No other positions are required for isometric view projections. So how do you draw the isometric projections? Let me go with the top of view. As I've told, 90% of the problems can be solved with the top of view itself. So first, let me draw one horizontal line. And then I draw two 30-degree angle lines on each other, either sides. This is how we draw 30-degree angle line on either sides. After you've drawn 30-degree angle lines, what you have to do is, you have to measure this distance, A1, B1 distance. I'm talking about A1, B1, because it is the base side of the prism. Keep in your mind, base side is A1 and B1. A1 and B1. That is how I've taken, and I've drawn it in joining here, this side. You can see, I've drawn it here. Similarly, I can name it B1 and C1. I can take distances as B1. I can take B as center. I can measure BC as length. This is 40 mm. It is converted into 0.8164. It is drawn here. 40 mm into 0.8164. Similarly, A1, B1 is drawn this side. Okay. So A1, B1, C1. These three lines from this side in the top of view. A1, B1, C1. A1 to B1, 40 mm into 0.8164. Similarly here, B1, C1, 0.8164 into 40 mm. We'll get the isometric length of the sides. And then we complete by joining the two lines, drawing parallel lines to these two lines, we get a point at B1. So it is simple in drawing the isometric projections. Okay. After that, what if you do? So what we've done is, we have drawn the Now we have drawn the base of the prism. I've drawn the base of the prism is drawn here. A1, B1, C1, D1. In the top of view, in the orthographic view, you can see A1, B1, C1, D1 in brackets, which is not seen. Whereas in the isometric projections, we are clearly seeing the base part of it. Okay. So after you have drawn the base part of the object, you have to draw the front portion. So I'm taking the height, 60 mm is the height I've taken. I've taken 60 mm length, that is A1 dash to A dash, this distance in the orthographic view. A dash to A1 dash length is taken. And then I'm drawing it here. How do I draw it? I'm converting 60 mm into 0.8164. I'm multiplying 60 mm into 0.8164 so that it is reduced into isometric projection. So I'm drawing 60 mm into 0.8164 length on all the four corners. This is how we draw it. Okay, length is constructed as vertical lines. Always height of the prism or pyramid or any of the images, if it is having height, they have drawn with vertical lines. Keep in your mind. So after joining it, these endpoints are there, right? So we join them. This is how we join them, and we can name them A, B, C, D. Only for you people's sake, I have shown the annotations. If not, no annotations are required. Okay? No annotations are required. I've told in the earlier points, remember, also telling that even in this isometric projections, hidden lines are not required, annotations are not required, and if you want to retain construction lines, you can retain it. If not, you can remove those also. So what we can do is, I'm just removing the hidden lines and hidden annotations. I'm just hiding it. So only this is required to be drawn in the final view. The construction is what you have drawn. You can retain it or you can remove it. The annotations what you have drawn, only for your reference, you can draw it. After that, you can remove it. At the same time, the hidden lines, what is not seen to our eyes, when you see in the isometric projections, those lines have to be removed. You don't write them, but you need to remove them. Only for the construction's sake, you can straight away, you can draw them first. After that, you can remove them. You can erase them. There is no harm in it. You'll get full marks. Only this construction is required. But make sure that the drawing, what you have drawn, it is to be isometric projection. It has to be in a reduced scale. That is very, very, very important. Apart from that, nothing is important. Okay. So first you have to reduce the scale. That is what is required. In computer work, what you can do is, you can draw to the scale first, actual scale. This is 40, this is 40, this is 60. And then you set the entire object and then go for scale command, reduce the scale into 0.8164. It will become reduced. That is how we draw the isometric projections in the solids. This is one of the examples. Let us go to the next example. Draw isometric projection of a square prism. So a square pyramid of base 30 mm and 60 mm. Okay. So let me draw a pentagon. This question is wrong. It's okay. Just concentrate on the diagram. I've taken a pentagonal pyramid. Okay. Pentagonal pyramid. And I'm making this base edge of 25 mm and height of 50 to 60 mm. So after you have drawn the pentagon, you know how to draw a pentagon, right? I've taken edge condition problem and you have drawn the pentagon. Draw edge condition problem and construct the pentagon with 72 degrees inner angles. Sorry, 108 degrees inner angles. 108 degrees inner angles. After that, you have to join the lines, that is medians, at least two minimum medians to be drawn to locate the center. Median lines, keep in your mind, median lines from one of the corner to the opposite side midpoint, that is called as median. You have to draw two lines or minimum two lines to locate the center of the prism, so pyramid. How will you draw? Two medians are drawn from A to opposite midpoint, DC. Similarly, E to opposite midpoint, BC. So wherever they cross, that becomes the axis point. Then join the corners to the axis line. This is how we need to draw the corners. This is how we have to draw prisms. You are not drawing any lines within side, within the box, in the front view. Whereas in the pyramids, you need to draw the lines. This is how we draw, because it is a slant triangular faces. This is called as slant triangular faces. They are inclined towards the axis of the pyramid. Okay, that is how we draw it. After you draw the top view, go for the front view. Before that, you can keep this in a box, so that if you keep in a box, it is easy for you to construct in the isometric projections. I have named it as 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see one edge and three corners are touching. That is how we have to draw. So make sure that whatever the box you keep, you should be, the object should be within the box. It should not be outside. It should be at least touching the almost all the corners if possible. That is how we need to draw. Then project the projectors. Draw the front view. Front view of axis 60 mm drawn. So length, axis I've drawn first. Before drawing the front view, axis to be drawn. In the pyramids, you can draw the sides. But whereas in pyramids, in prisms, you can draw side lines. Whereas in prism pyramids, you need to draw axis line first. You draw the axis line first, and then from that corners, you start joining. This is how we join to get the apex line here. This is called as vertex or apex. And you can name the points A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash and all. Okay, that is how we name it. After that, we start constructing the isometric projection. See, why we are drawing the orthographic projection? Why we are drawing orthographic projection is because we are drawing orthographic projection is only because certain dimensions of the objects cannot be measured straight away to draw on the isometric projections. So only we cannot take straight away the objects to be drawn on the isometric projections. So what we do is we try to keep the object in a box so that locations of the points can be easily measured and it can be transferred to the isometric projections. That is the important point. So only we use this box problem. Without using this box, it is difficult to construct this pentagon because we don't know where exactly this B is located and all in the isometric view. So what we do is we draw the isometric projections in the top view, draw the horizontal line first, then 30 degree angle line on either sides so that we can start with the top of view and then measure 1, 2 or 2, 3. Okay, we can measure 1, 2 or 2, 3. So that if I'm measuring 1, 2, I can take this side. This is isometric projection converted. I'm telling you, it has to be converted. 1, 2, you have to measure in the actual scale using the isometric scale. Convert it. Whatever the value you get for here, you have to convert it into isometric scale and you're locating it here. Similarly, you're measuring 1 and 4. You're measuring 1 and 4, converting into isometric scale and you are joining it. And then because it is a box, you can just join them. You'll get a box here this way. Now what you have to do is locate A, B, C, D, E points on the base part of it. So what we do first, let me locate the points. How will I do it? 1A, I'm measuring in the orthographic view. 1A I've measured. After measuring, I am converting it into isometric scale using isometric scale, 45 degrees to 30 degrees, and then I'm locating A point here. Then the same way, 1B, I've measured it here. Then 2C, I've measured it here. And 3D, I've measured it here. 4E, I've measured it here. Either way, you can do it. 3E also can measure it, or 4E also can measure it. You can convert it into isometric scale and locate the points. After that, join them. The base should be joined first so that we can get the points drawn. So how do you draw it? A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to A is drawn. Okay. After you've drawn the base of the pyramid, now draw the two lines. That is A to the midpoint of 2, 3, and you have to locate a point, this point to be located, right? So you can just draw one more line towards any of the box side. I can draw it this side or this side so that I can locate the 0.5. So what I've taken is on 4, 3 line, that is this line, I have marked 5 so that this distance can be located easily, so that OO1 can be located easily. So what I've done, I've measured O to midpoint, that can be drawn easily, because from here I can just draw parallel line to 1, 2, so that I can get the midpoint line. Then I've drawn this line, that is O5. O5 line is drawn, which should be measured from either 4, 5 or 3, 5. 4, 5 or 3, 5. This is to be drawn so that I can locate the center of the pyramid. This point to be located. For that reason, I've taken this point. Okay, I can measure. I've drawn one line, vertical line. From this point, I've drawn one more line here so that it becomes 0.5. So 4, 5 or 3, 5, I can take any distances. I can convert it to isometric scale and then locate it here on the isometric projection box. Then after locating the point here, I have to draw the vertical line. This is 60 mm line, right? 60 mm into 0.8164. This is the length, height of the pyramid. 60 mm into 0.8164. After you have joined the line from the axis, then join the corners from all the points. This is how we draw it. Corners. From all the corners you have to draw. This is how we draw the corners. After you draw the corners, make sure that you are erasing. Make sure that you are erasing non-seen lines or the sides of the pyramid. What is not seen? See, if you see in the front view, I cannot see ED. This line is not seen. DC is not seen. DO is not seen. They are hidden lines actually. Okay? They're not seen. They are hidden lines. So what we need to do is we need to remove them. Okay? We need to remove them. We need to remove the annotations also. We can remove the annotations also. So only the image is to be drawn. If you want, you can remove this box also. You can remove this box, but keeping this axis line, a 30 degree angle line to be kept. XO and OY. This line has to be kept with the horizontal line and the other things to be kept as it is. Whereas this box, you can remove it. That is how we draw the top view of the isometric projection of the pentagonal pyramid of 25 mm sides, 60 mm axis length.